the sun is going to shine for us. And our theme this year is harvest. As you can see, we have a nice lineup in the field here. And kicking off with the binder. For those of you who can remember that far back, this binder, in fact, comes from Mr. McKeshy in the Bridge of Weir. It was new to his grandfather in 1945, he tells me. I'm afraid we're only going to show it in the transport position today. We haven't time to take it down to the working position. It's a 1940s Massey Harris Sunshine, an Australian binder. The original binder was designed by Massey Harris in 1882. So this is a 1940s model, and it's probably one of the last binders that were used in this part of the world. So for those of you who don't know the ins and outs of it, the crop is cut, it's tied into sheaves with twine, they're then stooked, they're built into ricks, and the ricks are then threshed over the winter. So that is the sequence of events in the old days when they used the binder. So if we go on to the next stage now, from the binder we moved on to the combine. The labour requirement was much less. We had one man here cutting many more acres than the binder did in its day. And the one that's coming up now is from Gavin Stevenson at Stewarton. It's a 1962 Massey Ferguson 400, self-propelled. This one, in fact, was made in Kilmarnock. And again, the original... The original combine by Mr. Harris was built in Canada in 1938, so this is moved on from there. This one, in fact, is 50 years old today, well, this year rather. Earlier models were baggers and tailed combines, but self-propelled ones were the post-war ones. And there is an interest in this area anyway. Massey Harris had the factory in Kilmarnock, which produced combines and the Massey Harris tractors from the 1940s into the early 50s. There's a wide range of manufacturers post-war, anything from 6 foot cuts up to 30 and 40 foot cuts now with modern combines, so that gives you some comparison with how things have moved on. If we move on to the next stage, and again, this is part of the harvest scene, it's also part of the haymaking scene, but the Viking Lily Acrobat we've used as the only example of the hay turner, hay tedder, rake or side rake or whatever. This Viking Lily Acrobat, it's on the Massey Ferguson 35 from Jimmy Wilson at Ochiltree. It's a 1957 Ferguson grey and gold. It's the last of the Ferguson tractors before the Massey Ferguson ones took over. The machine here is used for growing up, for side raking and so on, and it's one of many different manufacturers of this type of machine. So progressing from there, we then come to the baler. Once you've got your straw lined up, rolled up with it with the Acrobat, then we come to the baler. And again, this one comes from Gavin and Willie Stevenson. It's operated today by David Thompson with his 1965 Massey 65. It's a 1968 Massey Model 28. So it's one of the earlier Massey combines, again, making small square section bales, man-sized bales, which can be handled very readily on the farm. They can either be in a bale. Here we go again, a tow rope again. Why is it always when you see John McNair, there's a tow rope in evidence somewhere? Right, the live tractor is John's narrow David Brown 885, more used to working in the berry fields of Dundee or somewhere in that area, I think, originally, and gradually found its way through to the west here. So that's a David Brown narrow from John. And coming in behind it, it was going last time I saw it, but this is before and after. This is a before one. The 770 Selectomatic David Brown from Russell McNabb. He's a better one coming in behind here. But this is the before event as opposed to the after one. So make your comparison. Next year, come and see this one in the same shape. Okay, Russell, thank you. Right, driver. Now you're up.
You want a push?
I'll not give you the microphone, so I'll just carry on.
You're going to shoot? You're going to have a tantrum?
Do you want some advice on how to start it?
Ask if Russell gave me a hook.
Can you give it a push? Driver. Driver. Driver.